Russell.
Well, we see all eight participants in their chairs. The round is to begin shortly. I see in the top right, Fabiano Caruana with the white pieces against Pragnananda. That promises to be an excellent matchup between two players with sometimes quite different styles, and you don't know what to expect from them. And then we didn't touch upon Alireza Firouzja with the white pieces against Gukesh. David, all that blitz chess, do you think that will help Firouzja just overcome some of his early struggles against one of the co-leaders in Gukesh?
Well, we see the handshakes. I do believe that blitz can be a good form breaker. If you're playing well, don't play blitz. It might ruin your rhythm. But if you're struggling, often getting the confidence of playing quickly, getting the moves out on the board, just forgetting, it can be, it can be a real positive. But we'll see at this really elevated level. It's hard. You need to stay in the zone. And whatever Firouzja has been doing the last 24 hours, he's got to hope that it really kind of sets him in a new mindset. But okay, Hikaru on the top left. It looks like he was smiling at something. The other players look... Yes, disappointing because he banked so much on this game. If he'd won with white, taken down one of the leaders, he would have had a great chance in the second half of the tournament. But I don't think he can really blame himself here, Hikaru. He didn't really leave many chances, Jan. Just great, great accurate play. That whole middle game onwards, especially bishop takes g3, knight f4 check. And I just want to say, nice to see the mind games, Jan Stead. Hikaru down there for a second. And Peter, that's something we often see at all levels, just keeping an eye on the opponent, kind of coming to terms with what's inevitable now.
Yes, it's always so important to try to get a feeling of your opponent. Yeah, Queen G2 check, as Robert beautifully highlighted. Yeah, Black will just keep on harassing White's king. Checks will be coming in on the light squares. And the special construction with Black's pawn on A5, White king can never run out yet towards b4 and a5 because that pawn just fixes the b4 square. I also would say, like, what a game. Yeah, it's this really shows what modern chess is about. You have an insane level of preparation is involved, but still the players, the gladiators, are fighting it out. You cannot prepare everything till the very end, and then you have to show some brilliant chess, and this is what they are showing us.
Clash of Titans. These two have really brought their best to today's game. And you see the players, they're going back and forth, queen chasing the white king. Hikaru doesn't want this game to end in a draw, but he doesn't have a choice because Jan found every correct continuation, even this one. I actually took it for granted that this would be a draw no matter which way you went, but you had to find the right squares to check from. The light squares is where the queen belongs. It's where the queen sits. And it looks like after king up to c3, the queen will continue to give the checks. Peter, you made a great point. The a5 pawn seemed irrelevant for most of the game, but it makes sure that the white king cannot scamper and find safety.
Yeah, Peter, I just want to say that a5 move early in the opening, you said it's an idea, but I mean, it looks inspired now. A5, clearly this was the plan. 25 moves later, just to box in the white king.
I will be opening my files after the game. And if I see this final position in my file, I wouldn't be surprised. But no, I do believe that at some point, some small inaccuracy happened. But it was the true spirit was very much in the game with knight d7, knight f6, king g8, knight e4.
And the players here, they've repeated a couple times. And Jan Nepomniachtchi quickly placing his queen on f3. And this should be the repetition, as there is no avoiding the checks. The players look at another, they shake hands, and a draw is the deserved result. The players, they want to know what the opponent was thinking, but nothing separated these two. A point separates them in the tournament, but Jan Nepomniachtchi holds with the black pieces. They're talking through all of the possibilities. Hikaru, he does have a smile on his face, but you could see the pain just minutes ago as Jan uncorked bishop takes g3. David, this was such an epic clash. A draw was the result. People, they hate on draws.